Yeah.
You know? And they tested me. I saved up thousands of dollars.
Yeah.
They've seen no drugs, no alcohol.
Yeah.
And I've been working since I was a kid.
Yeah.
I used to work at McDonald's over here when I was 17.
Okay.
When I was 14, I worked at some other little restaurant in West San Jose.
Yeah.
Since I was 14 years old.
Yeah.
But I did mess up. I was taking drugs, alcohol.
Yeah.
End up in jail. Come back out.
Yeah.
Under the influence of something, or drunk in public.
Okay.
Come back out. Back then, you could find a job within a week. Within 2 weeks, find a job, no problem. But now it got so crowded.
Yeah.
So many different people, it takes a lot longer to find a job.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of competition.
Yeah.
And then when you do find, when you do go to an interview, and if you don't have, no experience in the job that you applied for, you got to convince them, man. They tell you, well, how can we be sure that we can depend on you when we hire you? And because you don't have experience in this department. Well, look, man, I'm a fast learner. I like to keep busy, and I learn quick, and I like to just keep busy, man, and make the day go by. I like to work. You have to sell yourself out to them.
Yeah.
And then you convince them, and they say, well, okay, can you start tomorrow?
Yeah.
Can you start next week? You sound like a good guy, like we can trust you. I can start anytime you say, as soon as possible. While you're hired on this day, come in this day. And we'll get you your uniform or whatever you need. You know, you sell yourself out to get in to what you can, man.
Yeah.
And I've done the concrete. I've even demolited concrete.
Yeah.
You know, I've done stuff like that. I've done different foundation. I've done different stuff, man. A lot
Well, you know, but I can see you're a hard worker, so that's a good thing. That's okay, you know, but you have experience already. So the only thing, you haven't found the chance. You haven't you haven't get the chance to get a decent job.
Society would not give me a chance. They did once, they thought it'll be the same.
It is because your background, right?
No. They thought he's gonna get drugs, he's gonna get alcohol,
okay.
He's gonna end up in jail, but it failed.
Yeah. So but you know what? Something like you don't have to worry about right now, it's like don't worry about those things anymore. I'm gonna tell you why.
I have to, because I
listen.
I need money.
Well, listen. Just I want you to listen to what I'm telling you. Now do not focus your mind and all your being on perishable things, which is money, material things like cars, houses. This is what I'm telling you. At this point, I wanted to say this without offending you. Just try to focus your mind now on your heart, your mind, and Jesus Christ. I'm going to tell you what. You might know this. We are in the last days, right? Can you notice this?
The beginning. The beginning of
life. So you already have heads up on that.
Predictions to take place.
Yes.
You got the 666.
Yes.
The mark of the beast.
It's about to happen. Okay. I like that exactly. You have already like a little advantage knowledge about this. You have knowledge about this.
Knowledge.
Yeah, exactly. So you have knowledge enough to assimilate what is coming, right?
Yeah,
exactly.
Smart,
so that's the thing. So now, honestly, Jesus Christ is gonna come to put on fire all those perishable things, including people that they love this world. You know what I mean? Because this world, it'll be burned. You know that, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what's the point for the rich people to focus on, you know, making more? It's like sinning more over the sin, sinning. You know what I mean? So,
there are rich people who are good people, but the majority of them ain't worth it. They are nothing.
So I'm here to letting you know that, you know, we do, if you really want to call yourself son of God, you must act and walk similar to Jesus Christ. I'm going to tell you why. Looking to your neighbor, loving your neighbor as you love yourself. That's the main law written on your heart.
What does that
right?
mean to you? Love your neighbor as you love yourself. What does that mean to you?
Well, it means like, you know, if I see you needy, I'm going to help you, right? So I just came from the little bridge on the, 87 freeway. You know, I was talking to them. I was preaching with them. I was, you know, reading the Bible a little bit. And I gave them food. I run out of food, but I'm giving you like a little, you know, $10 at least. How many God, people is passing by right here? They don't even look at you.
It sounds like you know the Bible, mm-hmm. and God will bless you multiple times. What means multiple is more than three yeah. times. Forgiving.
Yeah.
Forgiving. Mm-hmm. It's better to be a giver than a receiver.
Exactly.
And if you give to someone yeah. in need,
see,
what
amen.
You gave me now, mm-hmm. He will bless you if it's from your heart.
Yeah.
If you did it, He'll bless you
it
more
is.
Than three times.
Yeah.
More than three times.
The thing is, you know, like, if you love your neighbor as you love yourself, I'm doing the favor to myself, you know what I mean? Because we are one spirit, you know? The spirit that I have is the same that you have. You know why? Because it's the same that is keeping your heart, you know, bumping the blood. It's keeping your heart, you know, beating, you know? It keeps you alive, breathing. So everything in this earth belongs to Jesus Christ. He created me, He created you.
He gave it to the devil to control the
world.
Well,
He stole it, actually.
He got angry with man.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why He gave it to him.
But actually, He stole it, actually.
But He decided to come back in the world and give him a freedom of choice.
Yeah.
Come my way or go your way.
Yes, exactly.
Not forceful,
exactly.
Not nothing.
Yeah.
But the devil is forceful because it makes you hate, fight, gangs, barrios, drugs, alcohol, marriage breakups, separations, lose children,
so,
jails, prisons.
Yeah.
That's the devil. He's forceful.
Yes.
God is free. You
mm-hmm.
come
mm-hmm.
and you get peace of mind.
He's
merciful.
Yeah.
Merciful.
Yeah.
But the thing is, back to what you said about love your neighbor.
Yeah.
That's how tricky the devil is.
Yep.
He makes you do something to your neighbor that is the devil.
Mm-hmm.
He studies the Bible too.
Yeah.
And
he knows the Bible too.
He does the wrong by the Bible.
And yes.
The thing is, you know, love your neighbor.
He corrupts the
love
Bible.
Your neighbor does not mean.
He corrupts the Bible, yes.
Love your neighbor does not mean your neighbor, your next door neighbor.
No.
You know what that means? It means your neighborly countries, all people around
yes.
you. Love your neighbor. People around different countries everywhere. That is your neighbor.
It's called.
Don't go to war with other countries
yes,
or other people
exactly.
around you.
Yep.
Love them too.
Yep. Yep.
That's your neighbor.
So
that's
the neighbor, it's the less fortunate people. People in jail, people at the hospital, you know, dying, homeless people, right?
People in jail.
Matthew 25 says, right? Because you saw me hungry, you gave me food, you saw me thirsty, you gave me water. You saw me naked, you clothed me, you saw me in jail, you visited me, you saw me in the hospital, and you visited me. Okay, he said, whoever have done those actions for the less fortunate people, it is doing it to me. So it makes sense because if I do good to you, I'm doing it to myself. You just said it, right? He will multiply the favor that I'm doing it to you, but actually I'm doing it to myself. And this is the right thing to do, you know what I mean?
Well,
so,
all right, so. If you know, if you did it from your heart or you just did
exactly.
it for whatever reason, but if it's from the corazón,
mm-hmm.
the corazón is going to bless you, man, multiple times
yep.
from the heart. But if you mm-hmm. didn't do it from the heart, you just did it because you want to get information, you want to talk or whatever your reason, some other reason, and just feeling for someone. If it's a human blessing feeling,
exactly.
and you gave out of the heart, not for any other expectations.
This is the
favor in return.
Yeah,
you will be blessed.
No,
that's why them churches.
Even the Satanists, they know that. So, here's the thing. Jesus Christ jumped out of his throne, you know, from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
He was having all the angels, you know, adoring him, right? Around him, he was just having a good time on his throne. But he decided to jump out of his throne, right? Like, not even resisting that he was God, right? Because he's God, Jesus Christ. He decided to come as a man, like a man, and walk and teach him to us how we're supposed to pass this test. We are here because we sinned against the Father. We used to live in heaven, but here's the thing. Before Satan take the one-third of the angels with him, the second third is you, me, all the humans in this earth. The first third defended the God's throne, right? So we are here because we were doubting about the Father's love to us. So he decided to put us here